detective drama without the rose-tinted nostalgia. Instead, George Gently promises a gritty and realistic snapshot of the era when law and order is being tainted by corruption.
Fresh from his role as Judge John Deed, Martin Shaw stars in the title role, a tough old school detective, that's what he is. Lee Ingleby plays his headstrong young sidekick, Detective Sergeant Backus. We're going to be meeting them both in just a moment. Hello to you both. First though, let's have a little look.
You John Backus?
Yes. Mr. Gently, sir.
Very impressive.
Aye, very popular with ramblers and... Well, ramblers. I prefer city life, personally.
I meant the MG.
All right.
Not standard issue up here, is it?
No. Wedding present, that.
Mum and Dad?
My mum's dead. My dad got me one of those pop-up toaster things. No, I bought the car for myself.
You needed cheering up?
Martin and Lee, join us. Hello to you both. As soon as you showed that shot, we all know, look at that car. Yeah, Fantastic car.
That's
great
much
drama.
What we said yeah. the day.
Yeah. You had a duff one.
I had a pretty duff car.
I had a nice one.
But the point about it is, you know, it's attention to detail. It's a really, really good drama because I was watching it last night. The attention to 1960s detail is really key, isn't it, too?
Yeah. Absolutely, yeah. Well, I mean, everybody likes nostalgia.
Yeah.
And as you say, the attention to detail was perfect. We had a great designer, got a wonderful writer. And for me, it was great because I was there, you know. I remember the 60s and these cars.
Did you have to teach him a lot about what the 60s were like before? Because it was just before
the revolution.
I had to teach
him about everything.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, I mean, how to open
acting.
The caravan door, everything.
Too much.
Terrible.
Explain your roles, because it's like, I hope you won't mind me saying this, it's a bit like Morse and Lewis, only a lot grittier. Did you think that as well? I mean, that sort of, you know, the young guy who's learning from sort of old prison cop.
But I think, they're both sort of very headstrong in a way. And, you know, Martin's character's what my character deems to be quite old school.
Yeah.
And I think Backus deems himself as a modern man that he needs to get with the times, really. And it's a kind of a clash of cultures, really, and trying to find their respect with each other as well, and it's a great series for that. I think the relationship that they both have.
It is a very good relationship.
Yeah, I mean, I think it got to be about the relationship actually, because for a start, it's brilliantly written, and if you've got a wonderful script, it just happens for you, you know. And then because we got on so well, it just developed from that, and it sort of develops into a father and son sort of scenario, you know, because the. George Gently is grieving because of his wife, and he has no children with that wife, and then there is somebody to teach, you know, and to focus his attention on. Mm.
And at a time when policing was about to enter very, very controversial time in terms of corruption.
Too. Mm. Yeah. Mm. Well, I mean, nobody knew what PC was then. Mm. People were much more pragmatic about it, and they just did what was required. You know, the old-time policeman, if somebody was misbehaving, he'd say, oh, he don't do that, wallop, you know.
Yeah. I think a lot of people would like to, well, I mean, you know, I was going to say bring those times back, but, you know, perhaps we've gone too PC. There's a great moment in the drama where you actually drag the suspect over the desk like this.
Reaches over and gives him a clout
when he answers back. So did you have to do, how did you research? I mean, did you do any research for this, or did it just land on your desk and you read it?
Well, it was kind of there in the script, really. Yeah. I mean, apart from talking to Martin about his 60s days.
Yes. Just boring everybody with my anecdotes.
Yeah. Mm. I'm just thinking back to the because you've had some very strong characters played. The Professionals, was that late 60s or early 70s?
That was early 70s.
Early 70s, yeah. So yes, it's after. But you had that character, then you had Judge John Deed, and now another police officer. I'm just wondering, which one takes prominence now? Is it Judge John Deed, or are we going to see more of George Gently?
I can't answer either of those questions. I wish I could. Mm. As far as John Deed is concerned, I think that whole thing is on a sort of a sabbatical, on a kind of a wait and see. Mm. And everybody's taken a step back to reflect. as far as our show is concerned, I think it depends on probably on something as simple as the ratings.
How many people watch?
I tell you what, it could really easily be a series, though, because you could see people buying into that. And as you say, there's a real thirst for nostalgia. Life on Mars has done fantastically well.
Yeah.
I mean, it's very different from... Do you mind being a bit minded about Doyle and the old days and professionals? And what do you think when you look back at that time?
I don't mind being reminded about it. I just find it so remarkable that so many years later... It's still such an issue, you know. I think it's on. It's still on, you know.
Is it?
I think it's ever been off
somewhere.
The screen.
Everything's banned in this global digitalized. Everything's banned beyond somewhere.
I'll watch it. Yeah. I loved it.
It's got a sort of cult status these days.
Yeah.
It has got it. Yes, I am a bit of a cult.
Don't look so miserable about it. It's a good thing.
Did I say that out loud?
You did.
You did. It's all right.
You did. We've been doing that all morning. Don't worry about it. We've been saying all sorts of things we shouldn't. Lovely to see you. It's great. It's on Sunday. It's 9 o'clock.
Yeah.
BBC One.
Yeah.
Lee Martin. Nice
Thank
to see you.
You.